Strings and rusts are often one of the first things that trip up newcomers to the language. Unlike most languages, which choose to hide the complexity of string data, Rust does its best to balance ease of use with the reality that strings are not as simple as they may seem. So what are strings all about? Well, first, Rust string type is always valid UTF-8. And unlike in some languages, like C, Rust strings are not null byte terminated. Likewise, Rust strings are not simply collections of character values. In fact, there's not just one string type in Rust. Rust actually has multiple string types. Luckily, normal string usage comes down to just two of these types, but keep in mind that Rust has other string types for certain special situations. The first type of string we'll be dealing with is capital S string values. These are known as own strings, which we're illustrating here with a function that takes a string and returns its length. Since these strings own the string data associated with them, they're responsible for freeing the data when it's dropped. This means that when a value of type string goes out of scope and is dropped, their string data is freed. What is a value of type string composed of? Let's take a look at the string contained in the variable s, as well as its associated data that lives on the heap. S is composed of three parts. First, it contains a length in bytes, 6 bytes in this case. Next, the string has a capacity, or how much room and memory is reserved for this string to use before we need to allocate even more memory, 8 bytes in this case. If our string grows by 3 more bytes, the string no longer has enough capacity, and the string will automatically allocate more memory. Finally, the string contains a pointer to the data it owns. The string points to the entire data it owns. But what if, for example, we only want to view a particular part of the string memory, like the first line of our string? This is where the second string-related type ampersand str, often pronounced ampersand str, or called by its longer name, string slice, comes in. This type does not own its data, and the string data is not freed when the value is dropped. This type represents a view or windows, often called a slice, into string data. Let's look at code that finds the first line of the string s. We do this with the lines method. We call next on the return value from lines to get the next line, which in this case is the very first line. And then we call unwrap, which will crash our program if the string contains no lines, something we know is not the case since the string in question, s, has 2 lines. We store this in a variable called l, which is of type ampersand str. Ampersand str, unlike capital S string, is composed of only 2 parts, a length and a pointer to the string data. L does not have access to the rest of S's string data. And while we have L, we won't be able to change the data S owns. L is an immutable view into data S owns. Rust guarantees that as long as we can use L, S cannot be dropped. You may have seen that string literals are of type string slice. Now we have tools to talk about why. String literals are embedded directly into the binary executable or library you're building. We can't treat them as capital S strings because we can't own this data. Instead, they are string slices or views into the binary string data section. A common operation in many languages is to get a character at a certain offset in a string, treating the string just like an array. This isn't allowed in Rust, as Rust strings are not arrays of characters. Rust strings are UTF-8 encoded. This means a logical character can be anywhere between 1 byte, as with many ASCII characters, or even 4 bytes big, as with many Chinese characters. In other words, not every byte of string data represents one character. Sometimes it represents only part of a character. This is why Rust requires us to be explicit about how we want to access string data, by bytes, by characters, and more. If you're coming from a garbage collected language, Rust strings might feel confusing. Rust is forcing us to acknowledge the complexity of human writing systems. But don't worry too much, most of the time you won't need to pay too much attention to this complexity. Let's jump over to a demo to see strings in action.